had issues, Shocks has had Skull, you know, all of them have been relatively busy during the past month, but they've tried to do as much online practice as possible. And so you can see that they seem poised and ready. And we'll start off EPSILON versus LEMONDOGS with the wonderful knife round, the most enjoyable round of the game, without a doubt. We'll be meeting up at mid, and we do remind those who are new to Counter-Strike that the winner of this knife round here will actually decide which side they'll start off as, whether they'll be the beret-wearing terrorists with the white masks, or the gas masks in the CTs. So, some interesting little spot in there. Goodness me, a bit of gangster knife fighting here. You just hear groans and grunts as they cut each other up. Looks like, though, EPSILON might be getting the better of LEMONDOGS. Ooh, Cobra with 2 kills, actually. Oh, 3! This man is an absolute ninja. Oh, and he gets the round for them. This is actually one of the more exciting knife rounds. Yeah. But Cobra with 4 kills. And I guess that's good for LEMONDOGS. They start off on the CT side. They start off on the stronger side. And the stronger side, not just in this map, but for them as well.
3 stabs from Zevis there. 3 assists. Pretty good. But yeah, let's see what we can expect. I mean, what I'll be expecting from LEMONDOGS here is probably, like, we usually see in a pistol round, CTs with a double peek here, and that's really important because you want to take the long ranges, and the terrorists want to get on top of you with those Glocks. That's really, really important. And so we need to see Delpan and HMP, you know, peeking in here. Let's go to Delpan very quickly. Where is he? Just find him. There he is. We need to see Delpan really getting a quick pick here, and he can't get anything. And what and the counterplay to this has been to smoke mid from you know, near T spawn to deny those long ranges from the CTs and those picks before they get on top of them. And we're seeing now they're really closing the distance. They haven't even shown themselves yet, and LEMONDOGS are trying or are just moving back reactively because they want to stay at distance. So this is really good movement from the French side, and they're in a really nice position. They force LEMONDOGS all the way back. They can double back through to B if they want. They can go through to CT spawn. They can do a lot right now.
Yep. Looks like we have put a nice smoke that gives him a, or forces Delpan to not see that push into CT spawn. But Cobra's there to notice that. Shocks will take him down, and they might double back towards bomb site A, or are they going to continue to bomb site B, or are they just taking their time, seeing if they can get any picks from the rotating CTs? Interesting here by the T site, and a very well executed little push through on site into bomb site B. The CTs dancing, Zelos getting away from the crosshairs of the terrorist side, but he's kept himself alive. He's given them the bomb site, but he's still ready for the retake. But Yushima, 2 kills both on that. There's only 2 men left for LEMONDOGS. Looks like it's a very successful pistol round for the T side, but they might get a bit punished here by Delpan and Zelos. Zelos and Delpan get a kill each. Zelos, maybe, actually, finishing off the side. They have to be careful. Mistu has to hide here. He doesn't want to die early on, but without a defuse kit, Zelos, even getting those 4 kills, will be unable to win the round.
That's actually a big deal, too.
LEMONDOGS. But earlier on, it is, because now he can actually...
Look at his money.
He can actually buy something if he'd like to, but the he does. He does get an SMG.
Yep.
Zelos. And the rest and armor. So the rest of his team are going to go for the CZs and armor. So actually, they look pretty nasty, LEMONDOGS, right now. Yes, they have to be careful. If they push into bomb site B, Zelos can do quite a bit of damage.
I'm not sure if I like this though, because this is really bad against armor. The Bison, you need to be hitting the heads. He's just going to go for them. I mean,
it's
going to
get completely destroyed, especially from like distance against rifles. It's just,
I mean, what I would have preferred to see him do is just to either save the money or dropping pistols or something like that, because if he, I mean, that's money that he could have used for a quick AWP on one of his teammates. We're stuck on his POV there. For a quick AWP on one of his teammates, and I don't know, the Bison, the reason why we don't see Bisons nearly as much these days, or the SMGs altogether, is because they're bad against armor. They're really, really bad.
Yeah, the money bonus though.
And that's true, but
I think that's maybe what he was aiming for. Maybe it's getting 1 or 2 kills so he can get the AWP early on for Delpan. Because, you know, they do want to get the AWP as soon as possible.
But it's definitely really, really tough to get those frags. I would have liked to have seen, you know, a mag or something in favor of
Swag 7.
Yeah, the Swag 7, because it was just more effective. It's just you're going to get the kills more reliably than a Bison. Because a Bison, it's quite inaccurate. It's about landing a lot of bullets. And so the armor really soaks up the damage there. Either way, you know, they're taking it slow, our EPSILON. They're not going to... Not going to risk anything here.
Yeah, because we've got an armor buy, so we'll have to be a bit careful. HM will be able to get a kill from behind. Nice positioning by him, but it's pretty tough now. He's got a one-on-three situation with the bomb planted. Very unlikely he'll be able to do much. Coming in here from apartments. There are two terrorists on Pit. Pit is just one of those positions that is horrifically powerful in bombsite A control. You know, if you have two men or one man in Pit, if you do have control of Pit, you can do so much in both the defense and offense of the bombsite. But he'll go, he'll save his armor, and he'll save his CZ. It's the best choice for him at this moment. And Epsilon will get the second round of the game.
Yep, indeed. I'm still a little bit sad with the Bison choice. I don't like it at all. But either way, you know, LemonDogs, hopefully, for their sake, they're able to get things together money-wise sooner rather than later. And you know, we can see that, of course, because Zelos got so many frags, it didn't have a massive impact compared to the rest of his team on his money. They still will be on, you know, similar buys. But anyway, we'll see how Epsilon handle this. They've been doing a really nice slow place so far on the anti-eco. They're going to be aware that another one will happen. So will they run into the stack or not? That's the question.
At the moment, you know, four men in bombsite B, they've put their money on one number at the moment.
That number is a letter.
Yeah, the number is a letter. What's the game that people play when they bet on numbers? I can't remember the name. I'm not a gambler.
No,
my gambling
roulette?
Expertise. Yeah, no. Roulette. That's it.
Yes.
Roulette, yeah, okay. My gambling expertise is maximized with my knowledge of CSGO Lounge. That's the limit of my gambling expertise. But it might be that the T's at the moment are testing the water, seeing if they can kind of figure out where the CTs are. And this is good by Epsilon, because if they push into bombsite B willy-nilly without really thinking about it, they're going to be punished. But if they don't figure out that there's only one man on bombsite A, they're also going to be punished as well. So they have to get the information, but it looks like it might be a slow push here into bombsite B. They have to be very careful. The flashes go up. There are four men waiting for them. Will the CTs be able to stand in front of this raging French attack? Zevas through the smoke, getting a kill. Delpan as well, able to take down two men, but that's not enough as Kiyoshima will dispatch of Zelos. And HMP, the late recruit, and the late defense will not be useful whatsoever for the Swedes as Epsilon pick up the third round. But now they're finally able to go for a buy. Delpan getting the armor without the helmet, same with Zelos, but he does have the AWP now. And standing on two kills and three deaths, he's seen better days indeed. But Inferno with the AWP, will he be able to do any damage with it? Will he be on form like he was yesterday and take his team to victory?
Oh, a bit of aggressive. It was to be an aggressive move, but deterred by the grenades. Delpan, though, that's going to give him the cue. He's going to know that the players are moving in. He got the shot, and actually this is quite a strong three-man setup going on here for B. This is not the right bomb site to go to. Epsilon better learn that sooner than later after that first AWP shot rattled off down Banana, taking down Mistu. And it does seem to be that they're spreading out a bit now. They're going to change their initial plan. They did take control of Banana, which may have been the original aim for them, but they are hanging around there, and Shox is alone in apartments. So it does seem to be the B player where Shox comes out of boiler slowly to catch the rotating players. So this is kind of what it looks like on the map right now from the common strategies that are used on this map. We'll see if it's going to be effective. We'll probably see quite a bit of time killed until it really gets going.
Yeah, they do have 45 seconds on the clock. They don't have to really push any times, but the flashes do go above. And Delpan's not going to be in the bombsite to support the rest of his teammates, so they do have a chance to actually take control of the site. GMX getting an early kill. Kiyoshima taking on Zelos. Delpan now smoked off. Oh, and that shot on SF was a stroke of luck for Delpan there. But 3-on-3, will Delpan rise to the occasion? So far, two kills to his name. So far, he's done the most damage against the T side. But HMP with a nice wall bang there on Shox. Now it's a 3-on-2 situation. It doesn't look very dandy here for the terrorists, but they don't have a lot of time on the clock. The CTs, HMP taking down Kiyoshima. GMX will take down Delpan, and GMX maybe will delay them long enough not to get that defuse. Will they have enough time? It looks like they'll be able to defuse it. Oh my,
oh,
no,
so
it was 1 second. Oh dear, Epsilon, very lucky there. Very, very lucky indeed. Because LemonDogs did an excellent job retaking the bombsite. And if it wasn't for Delpan's two kills earlier on, or two kills in that round, it would have been a very different story. But
at least they're able to cause some pretty bad economic damage there against Epsilon, killing all their team members. And it's pretty bad for their confidence as well, as, you know, Epsilon just realized, well, we're not very confident in the bombsite defense.
The thing for LemonDogs, though, is that their economy is being kept in check by... the thing for LemonDogs is that their economy is being kept in check by Epsilon constantly, and we can see that the reverse is also true. Epsilon, even on the ecos, we're seeing, you know, two frags at minimum, which according to Cadian is acceptable. That's a decent result. You get two kills on the eco, and they did that with the stack. You're doing a lot towards keeping your opponent's economy in check and not letting it grow too much. And we're seeing that that's the case for Epsilon. So LemonDogs just need a few good rounds to really bring this back. And oh, there you go, Shox getting a frag that perhaps he shouldn't have gotten there, and that's going to really benefit them on their apartment's control. Del Pan, though,
with a double.
That's important. Very important. Slowing them down.
But the smoke's pit good, is though. Completely smoked off. Now, they have to not make the mistake of planting the bomb and not trying to take control of... Goodness me, can he even get the other... He sees his head!
What?
Oh my, Delpan with a 4K. So far, can he make it an ace? It's Delpan against Team Epsilon. Cobra's gonna finish the job. Cobra taking away the ace of Delpan. And goodness me, Delpan with 4 kills that round. He is really getting on form. And finally, his form has benefited his side, as LemonDogs will get that round. 4-1 for Team Epsilon. And that was very interesting indeed. They made a mistake of just smoking off pit. And I was just going to say it. You cannot let Delpan mess around at pit. It doesn't matter how much you've smoked it.
And there's a bit of a gap there, unfortunately. But this is really very, very key timing for them. Because again, like going back to just the economy game, we saw that if they lost that round, they would have been up for an eco. And it was a round where Epsilon's money was also fragile. And we can see Epsilon are on a buy now here, but it's a shaky buy. Not many nades, some Galils thrown into the mix just to get be able to afford grenades. So if LemonDogs are able to win this round here, they completely screw over their opponents, Epsilon, money-wise. And that's going to start swinging the game, the momentum, all the way back towards the Swedes. And they're going to get a good edge. And that's going to be so, so crucial for them. But can they do it? This round is massively important for the game right now for LemonDogs.
Yeah, LemonDogs, if they're able to win this, they'll have to force Epsilon on eco. They'll get the third round, and also force Epsilon on some pretty bad, you know, economic disadvantage. Might get him the fourth. So they have to be very careful. Zev's there. Really actually, only double. Zealous helping him out from the other side. Goodness me, a triple kill there by Zealous. Very nice work there at mid, my LemonDogs. And they'll be able to win that round and force the Frenchman onto an eco. Not bad play here, my LemonDogs, at all. As Zealous and Zevit rise to the occasion and do some pretty good duo work at mid, at bombsite B.
They didn't even kill a single man, really, of LemonDogs. No. That's really important. To really make good of that kind of situation, what they're going to need to accomplish now is at least two or three frags, maybe more, on the eco. And it's possible, you know, they don't have to focus on winning the round here. Just getting the kills and forcing the rebuys of the weapons is something that can keep LemonDogs' economy in check whilst they try to get their money up to get those good buy rounds going. And it also, like, removes some grenades from them as well. Let's see if they're able to do it here. Shock is going to move onto the angle for HMP. HMP, though, deals with that quite successfully. And there's still some more opportunities here for Epsilon to make a few frags. And let's see if they're able to accomplish this. So important for them. And that's the end goal there. But this we are really game on right now. We're really game on between these two sides. It's not looking quite as bad as Dust 2 was to begin with. Dilpan with a frag there onto Misto. So only two players left to go deep here, and very well controlled. Just we saw them playing very far back, abusing the range. No nades from Epsilon, of course, didn't really want to overly invest in that. But now they get their buy round, and if we look again at the economy, this is getting into dangerous territory for Epsilon, because they need to get this. They need to get the frags now. That's two rounds in a row where no one died for LemonDogs. Look at the effect that it has on their money. It's actually ridiculous. And Delpan does get the kill onto GMX. Great play there. And an aggressive play, proactive stuff from the Swedes on Banana as well. This is a fantastic start to the round for LemonDogs.
It looks like LemonDogs are getting back into their mode of game, and Delpan is slowly reaching the dominance that he had and the dominance that we saw yesterday with his ult play. And this is really bad for EPSILON because they have to figure out how to stop them from using or taking advantage of Delpan's incredible AWP play here. At the same time, the rest of the CT side as well, they've not been doing bad. Nice little offensive positioning and aggressive positioning there in Banana. And that's going to actually really, really hurt the T's because now they're forced and they're funneled. They only have two men left against five, number one, and they're forced and funneled to go towards bombsite A, where Delpan will be waiting patiently for them with his AWP. So another round lost by EPSILON, and they're going to have to be forced onto another eco. This is really interesting, but a good shot there by SF, at least. And at the same time, this is another thing that, we have to take into consideration. They're not doing a lot of damage against LEMONDOGS. Yes, last round they got no kills, and this round they haven't got that many either, with only one. And on a bye round, that's not good at all.
They are going in here, very aggressive, and they've got to be quick. They're going to get flanked here. The frags are coming in, but not quite quickly enough. And I just want to highlight quickly, and just go into the free cam here. This is, again, meta game thing I'll quickly show here. Of course, you know, get the deep smokes to take control of Banana. We saw that from LEMONDOGS. And, you know, as the meta game develops, people figure out ways to deal with it. And we saw the boost here. So this boost looks over the smoke. Yep. So we had this position here. And unfortunately, they understood that, though. And they weren't peeking the angles that were visible, which is really the car. And so they handled it very well. So obviously, EPSILON know what they're doing. But so do LEMONDOGS, showing some very advanced thinking here.
Good need as well. And LEMONDOGS keeping that range advantage. Making sure they have quite a distance between them. Incoming terrorist. Shocks though with nice. A double. And SF with one. Actually putting it on a 2-on-2. Not bad here by Shocks, who picks up the AWP. This could be pretty bad for the CT side as Shocks will be able to plant the bomb. He'll get that nice economic advantage, that nice little financial boost from planting it, and you'll also have the AWP, and SF will pick up the M4. Now it's a very, very equal little setup here. Both players have guns. They are in pit. The CTs are in a bit of trouble. Zelos, though, will take down SF. Now it's all up to Shocks, who will miss his first shot. Cobra will come support his teammate, and that's a run for LEMONDOGS. Great job there by Zelos and Cobra, who are able to kind of defuse that pit defense of bombsite A. So, bomb planted by EPSILON. Very good eco by them, getting three kills and a bomb plant, but they could have actually even won the round.
Yeah, it was that result would have been very, very needed, because if we look at the money now, it's getting pretty, it's kind of a bit wonky for LEMONDOGS, but now they're still okay. They're still okay. Look, 10k, 6k, 9k, but imagine if they'd all died and not won the round there. I mean, or even just all died, it would have been a massive difference. And that's the difference that EPSILON need right now. And oh, aggressive play from LEMONDOGS. The Molotov does go down, but Cobra is going to be left alone. The floater has to come over to B to help him out. And it's a good start here for EPSILON. They're going to want to slow things down. This is the nice thing about getting really fast aggression right at the start of the round that's not overcommitted. Because then you force a reaction. You create an awkward situation for LEMONDOGS where they don't get to play their standard setup. And that's the important thing. You shake them off of their standard game. And that's what we see now. EPSILON, now it's up to them, after taking map control, to make a final call on how to play this out.
But I think that map control cost them a bit too much. You can take a look there. Kiyoshima on 35 HP, GMX on 35, and SF on 50. It makes them a lot easier and a lot softer for their other CTs to do quite a bit of damage on them. I mean, two nades and...
Look at this fake. It's actually working. They moved up this way, and that's going to... They're a bit coming slow. Back. They're being bitsy slow, though.
Well, the CTs have kind of figured out. They are sending one person there all up to Speedway, just in case, but looks like the CTs will be rotating back. And it's too slow here by Team EPSILON as the CTs are able to get back into their positions. HMP taking out GMX, losing a lot of HP. Would have been a different story if Zelos hadn't done that damage earlier on in the round. Might have not been able to take him down, but now SF is pushed to 33 HP. Delpan in the AWP, getting a kill. Shots. No, it's 3-on-3, but the bomb is planted. They do have control of the site. And they do have two flashes left. Flashes they can use pretty well. And a nice little movement here by the CTs to pretty much attack them from almost every single angle. SF able to take down Zevis. Delpan taking down SF with the AWP, and Cobra finishing off the job. A very nice and smooth retake here by the CTs, who are looking more confident as the rounds go by.
That was really impressive. I wasn't expecting that retake to work because there was a really good post-plant setup from Epsilon, and of course they had this area here smoked off. And we could see how helpless Delpan was with his teammate here. They were just, look at that, it's like half across right there. Like they were so helpless. And still though, when the smoke dissipated, they just connected those shots, man. You just can't fault these guys. Sometimes they are just so good. And Cobra coming in with the flank worked out perfectly. And again, there's the counter boost over the smoke. And oh, Delpan, that's so good there, because the whole point of that is that you're standing above the scope. But Delpan, he knows they're tuned, you know, they're very well tuned into the metagame, so they know how to deal with these things.
There's a lot of experience here by these veterans. They know how CS is played, but they do actually at least do put a lot of damage on Delpan, who at the moment is really the strongest player for the CT side. So an aid or a stray shot will be enough to end his AWPing dream for this round, anyway. But Epsilon now put in, well, they're kind of in dire straits. If they don't win this round, they'll be forced onto another eco. And it'll put LEMONDOGS 8-4 up against the Frenchman. But if they win it, it'll make it a 6-5.
So one cool thing to note is, you know, they pushed up Banana. Again, they could have actually committed to A. This is a very open map for them now. Pushing up Banana wasn't necessarily for them to go, let's go Banana. It's also for them to be like, okay, let's know or not if LEMONDOGS have Banana, because that's information they do or do not have. We're seeing them go for the A push though, the B push though, and good smoke there on Coils. Zealous is going to have to go on top, and this is a very exposed spot. How many? He's going to make two frags out of that. That's brilliant stuff there from Zealous. That could just be the difference that his team need. LEMONDOGS, they're coming in for the retake now, 2-on-2 instead of a 3-on-2.
Very excellent job there by Zealous. It could have been a very different story had he not gotten those two kills before his death. And now it seems more probable that LEMONDOGS will be able to win the 7th round, as GMX and Mistu are easily dispatched of by the remaining players of the Swedish side. So 7-4 and most likely 8-4. It's not looking so good for the Frenchmen, and I think we were wrong with our prediction in saying that Inferno won't be really the map for them. But we know that they're stronger on the CT side, and they started off as a CT side. And this is something they didn't have on Dust2. They weren't able to start off on the CT side.
Yeah, Delpan's getting with his AWP, so that's a really big deal for them. It's so important for him to make that work, and that's going to be the struggle on that T side indeed, as you just highlighted. Oh, almost getting a cheeky pick. This is very cheeky indeed, going this aggressively on a slower timing there, Delpan. Bit risky, but it's okay, no one there to punish him. Oh, what was that? GMX through the smoke.
Right through the smoke, and
look at this man. He's not even got a gun.
He's got the invisible AK.
There it is.
Oh, and there it is. He gets it back. He removes the cloak of invisibility.
He threw a rock, man. He just threw a rock through the smoke and just hit Delpan in the face.
He threw the bullets. He ate the bullets and spat them at him. GMX able to take down the most dangerous player on the Swedish side. So now it seems like it is actually possible for Team Epsilon to get this round. They have the bomb going towards bombsite A here, and it might be a bombsite A execute, but there are three CTs waiting for them, two on arch side.
I like this setup, actually. This allows them to play much more team play and also react very quickly if it's a B. So they kind of give A up a little bit and play for retake. But now they just decided to split 2-2. So they changed the setup again. And this is hold out for as long as possible and try, please, to work out what site it's going to be. Because they need to get that reinforcements in quickly and delay as much as they can, get as many frags as they can. You know, Pit's a good position. They've got a guy on library side as well. Let's have a look here. We've got HMP here. Very important. He's got to survive for a really long time here. If he can keep that pressure coming in from Pit, that's what his team needs to get the rotations in time. HMP goes down though, and Zealous and Cobra are forced to do a lot with very, very little.
That was a wonderful Molotov there by the T-sides, because they forced him to be in a position where they... In Pit, the greatest thing about Pit is your ability to kind of switch around the angle as much as you like and have that like little cover to hide behind. But they threw that Molotov that forced him to hold one angle, and so they knew exactly where he was. Mr. jumped on top of the car, surprised him, and they pretty much overpowered him. And after taking control of Pit, it was a pretty easy business getting into bombsite A. But five rounds for Epsilon. They're keeping themselves in the game for this half. They strengthening their economy. Molotov there down... Down Banana towards the car. They can get any of the aggressive CTs, and well, they got a Molotov back. And an interesting boost here. This is a really, really nasty boost on top in the bombsite. I mean, if you're not careful, you can never see that. And if the terrorists don't look up, they're gonna get death from above.
And certainly. And we can see that they're setting up for an A play here. We don't know just yet where on A they're going to go, because they could always go through CT Arch and smoke off quad, or they can just go for the pit smokes over. There's no one in position for the pit smokes right now, so it's very curious. I'm very curious to see exactly where they're going to go going to go with this. And you can see, of course, Zevis in that really nasty position. Here they are. This is the setup they have on the site. Got one guy all the way back in graveyard and one guy towards library or small pit in 1.6. And it's a decent setup. And let's see now if it pays off for them, because, yeah, we're seeing them go a bit arch side here. No smokes went over to pit, so a bit of pressure here on arch side. And they may just want to take control and sit on this. See how this goes here. They're making their way through. Kyoshima already got tagged down really low. And they're going to swing all the way around. Mistu with one frag and Shox as well, with two actually, putting it to a 2-on-1. Shox now with two men to find. Oh, and there is that 1-on-1 almost going the way. That would have been a big, big deal. Great Molotov.
Great Molotov there by Shox, giving him the time to plant the bomb. Excellent play by this master marksman. The Frenchman himself, Shox, will he be able to win this 1-on-2 situation? There is a crossfire setting up. He has to be very careful. Cobra coming up from behind. But actually, Delpan was the one who got the kill. And sadly, it will go towards Lemondog. Epsilon unable to win that round. And I want to mention, it's just really difficult to push into bomb site A when they have positions like that, when you have four CTs waiting for you.
Yep.
In the site with one in graveyard, two in outside, and one in pit. It's very, very difficult. Yeah. And it cost them too much. They lost too many men just to get control of the site.
I'm surprised about that, Ethan. You don't see that super often. Usually you see the pit smokes go over from second mid, and what that does is it completely blocks off pit. And we've seen pit smokes like that, and you get the really fast plant here. That's really effective.
Yep.
They decided to go without many smokes on A's. Only this and this was smoked off. So they were going for a lot of aim jewels, basically, to take the site, and it's really messy to do a play like that. So definitely Epsilon going for something a bit crazy, and now they're going for something crazy again. Look at SF, he's just beasting straight through apartments onto the bomb site. Kyoshima executing like a monster as well. They've got the site, they've got the smoke down. Should be decent post-plant situation for them.
Bomb is planted. Economy is still working out for them. Actually, all of a sudden, it's a 3-on-1 situation. It's up to Zilos now, and I don't think it's going to be very possible for him. Epsilon might be winning their 6th round of the game. That'll be a pretty good start for them, but Zilos is going to punish Shox, who hasn't been playing as well as we expect him to. He's not at the level that we really expect Shox, especially on Inferno, on the maps that we've seen Shox really, really shine with that amazing AWP ace at Banana against virtus.pro. So, at the moment, really, if we look at the scores, you see a lot of nice work there by Kyoshima. Actually, Shox with 14 kills to 12 deaths. He does have the frags under his belt. He is doing a good job, but maybe not as good as we expect from such a star player. But we do have the Mag 7 purchase here by HMP. It's kind of a forced buy, as it's the last round of the half. And if Epsilon can get the 7th round, it'll be excellent. But even with 6 rounds, that's not too bad on the CT side of the map. Not bad whatsoever. Knowing that Lemondogs are probably not going to be as successful on the T, and that Delpon won't be able to utilize the AWP as much as he can on the T. So Epsilon so far have done an excellent job just getting those 6 rounds as the T side.
So we're seeing a lot of traffic over towards the B side here. Of course, we've got a mag on Cobra, and he's got one more flash left over, and there is the pop flash position. Everyone knows this one, and this is pretty effective. He's got the range. If he gets them blind, this could be massive from Cobra. There goes the beautiful smoke there. Look at how that denies his position. He can't do anything now. And they're going straight for the plant. Oh, and he's going to be able to get it. He knows exactly where that was going down. They're going to swing in through construction. But I fear the damage was already done. Cobra in a good position. And it is the 3-on-3 right now. In the back of the site. Oh, he's got nowhere to go. Delpan and HMP left. An AWP and a mag. This is going to be really awkward here.
It's a bit of a weird situation to put yourself in as terrorists, smoking and not actually checking the bomb. So, I mean, that is a corner that people go and hide in a lot. So you should really try and check it. Unlucky by Delpan to actually not be able to finish off. I think he got a wall bang there. It's a 1-on-2. I mean, he doesn't have a lot of time left. He has to be quick about this. Yeah, it is possible here for Delpan. No scope. He's not going to find its target. Nor its mark. Mistu will finish off the job and get the 7th round for Epsilon.
The funny thing is, he was looking for that Molotov on coils, because that would have actually blocked the other guy off completely. But he couldn't get it because there's a smoke still there.
Yeah, there's a smoke.
And like he couldn't wait. He couldn't wait because the time was ticking away. He had to kill someone then to get to a 1-on-1 and then have a chance at the defuse.
Yeah.
It was quite cool. Mm-hmm. It was pretty funny. It's always funny with these post-plant situations, like Shox, for example, when he was in Boiler, and I can't remember who it was coming in from LemonDogs to go for the retake, but he just can't do anything. He has to chase Shox. Shox doesn't even have to shoot a single shot.
Yeah,
he's just pulling it further and further back. Exactly. He can't do anything.
It's
great, but we're seeing the second
time.
Yeah. 8-7. Are you happy with LemonDogs' performance? Do you think EPSILON could have done better? How do you feel about this now going into the next half?
LemonDogs have done a lot, but they have to have done better. They should have gotten at least 11 rounds against EPSILON if they wanted to win. Is that a love heart?
It is a heart.
Yes, it's a heart for everyone who's with us and viewing this game with us today. And we've got some pretty cool news as well. We'll be actually casting the Nip versus Titan game after this. That's a really, really cool game to cast indeed. And it's going to be the rivalry between the two greats, Nip versus Titan, after this. Do stick with us and tell your friends about us and tweet and Facebook and do all that wonderful social media stuff. That's why I spelled Titan.
Fancy overlays and Italian designers. You got me.
Italiano.
And a wireless mouse.
No, you can't really reach the same level as Simi. You know, Simi's design work is... You're hurting his his reputation. That.
All right.
But a nice smiley face anyway. I like it.
We're going live now to Thistle. So all the shenanigans from here over, and we get to see how EPSILON handles this again. Looking for these picks on mid. They're going for a three-man push on Banana. Let's see if that is going to work out for them.
Well, they have
that smoke I was talking about.
Yeah, they've put a lot of trust on Shox, to be able to help Mister take or defend bombsite A. Shox having to back away all the way to library due to the flashes and smokes. And Miz is going to be ready with the incendiary. If he doesn't die, if he gets to throw that before dying, well, he's not actually going to throw it. He's going to keep it. Nice there! Actually, it does do a bit of damage on Delpan. He knows that they're going to push through Boiler at the same time, but Mister has a really tough job ahead of him. They're pushing him all at the same time. At least he drives their fire, or takes their fire away from Shox for a moment. But oh, what a retake here by SF and GMX. All of a sudden, there's a double kill each, and they do have control of the bombsite. The auxiliaries and the support come at the right moment, and they retake the bomb site. Very nice job here by EPSILON, and the round that should have definitely gone for LemonDogs, who completely annihilated both Shox and Mistu without any injuries.
Again, this is why pistol rounds can be so fun, because you can have really, really nice strategies that are very smart and play against the meta game and everything, which is what LemonDogs did. They managed to get the smoke on mid in the right place, which is really, really good. They're nice, a lot of strength from EPSILON to pick at range. You can get your way in apartments and everything, get into good positions. But in pistol rounds, one player can just pop off everybody's heads with a pistol. Like, that can just happen. You can see the craziest things. And execution sometimes just completely trumps any kind of excellent strategy making and so on. So love to see that. And we're at 8-8 now with a good start on the second half for EPSILON. They would like to hold on to this. Shox, notably, with a CZ and not going for any rifles. Typically, this was, is to save for an AWP. But actually, commonly as well, it's to make sure that your economy stays good, because he might just be getting a rifle. But here we have the rush eco frags. Nom nom nom. Only two for SF though.
Nom nom nom.
Nom nom nom. delicious eco frags. That's big. That's big. That's a lot of money.
Oh, that's a lot of money on this eco round. Now it's 3-on-3, and they're all hiding. It's kind of like what's that game? What's that game where you kind of crouch and. Well, okay, there's hide and seek, but when you crouch in a line. Kiyoshima with a double. Is he going to make it a triple?
Oh my
GMX
God.
Is actually going to kill Kiyoshima. He's like, Kiyoshima, I will not dishonor you and allow your enemies to kill you. I will be the one who kills you.
And this is a massive deal right there, because not only was it a knife, but they got a lot of frags. And I was going to say, I was in the middle of making the point that often, what happens with Shox not buying there is not just necessary to have the option for an AWP, but it's also to have the option for a better economy and more nades if something goes wrong. And something went wrong there. Something went gravely wrong.
Look how they've got better guns than the winning side at the moment.
Yeah.
Pretty good with that knife, so.
that wall bang there is really nice, by the way, on Zelos. Let's see if he's, is he still doing it. No, it's, it goes all the way to the back of apartments. All the way. It's a great wall bang.
LEMONDOGS are now with a 4-by hit. Obviously losing control of this match on the T site. Interesting flash hit by Zelos. We don't know the reason for that.
Oh, Shock's distracting there. He's not going to expect this guy close left.
He has no idea, but he's going to back away. He does smell that there's something a bit wrong. Something's a bit iffy about apartments. And after throwing that flash and nade, he decides, you know what? I'm getting out of there immediately. Don't want to be surprised.
Oh, pit smoke. This should be the pit smoke. Let's have a look at this one. As it goes over, should be sailing over shortly. There we go, pit smoke here.
There you go. Ooh, some nice little camera action there.
Yep. Really important smoke, that is. You can get ones on front on top of the track as well to get the guaranteed plant, but this should be good enough for LEMONDOGS here. The superior weapon advantage. But Shox, look at him go! Taking down one player. He's in pit. This is a good position to keep hold of.
You see, you can't just smoke off pit and let the guy in pit survive, because the smokes are going to disappear and they're going to retake the bomb site. You have to try and kill them as soon as possible. And even though they got the bomb planted, it's going to be around for Epsilon. Delpan's the last man standing coming in from apartments, and it's 2-on-1. Ooh, he gets the first. Well, he gets the second. Oh, almost. The defuse actually works out for Shox. And Delpan was just a few seconds late.
He surprised Misto. That was really interesting, because there was they had no idea where the last guy was. So that means he must either he's hiding in sight somewhere, or he's hiding in boiler, or he ran around apartments. And there was stepping next to Misto. Delpan was running in apartments, and he didn't notice it. Yeah. That was very strange.
He probably thought that he was coming from our side for some reason. And he was making sure that Shox doesn't get shot from the side that he's opening. Do you understand? Because Shox can't be shot from apartments really easily. So it was a good, if he had a 50-50, so it was a good choice there by Misty. But we've got some interesting news for you. Na'Vi ahead 14 rounds tonight in the second map. So it might be 2-0. Virtus.pro might be out of the tournament. That's going to be a huge upset indeed.
That's big.
Now it's 15. Oh my god, Virtus.pro, they might be out for good. And Na'Vi, I mean, our predictions have just been, they've not been on point.
Here you go, look. Two players were left alive in pit. They're picking apart this this post-plant situation for LEMONDOGS. They're finally getting the frags to come in, and it's just Shox remaining in this position. But look how compromised he is right now. No grenades, nothing to block off angles. He's got to execute like a beast right now. Shox cannot do it.
Sadly.
10-9.
It's tough. It's tough, especially when you can be attacked from so many angles. You're kind of looking all over the place. But CTs will be now having to play an eco. All right, and they're 10 rounds up. I mean, LEMONDOGS are most likely going to get their 10th round. But if they do really well on the eco and do a bit of economic damage, that's good enough. They don't have to win this round. It's not win all or lose all for them. Win all or end all. What am I saying? I can't even... I don't know the phrases. Do I speak English or am I speaking a different language? Maybe I'm speaking a different language here. Zelos actually unable to afford a gun. And GMX in this really nasty position here with that Nova. Honestly, in apartments, it's just so horribly effective. If he's able to get an AK-47 for his teammates, that'll be good as well. It might be a bombsite B push here by the T's, who haven't actually done that yet in this half. Molotov at Sandbags, just in case there's a pesky CT hiding there. Actually, it didn't really land at Sandbags. A bit of fun in that, but I think the heat would have drawn him out.
Yeah, so it's a good Molotov. It's a good Molotov. It's peace of mind. Even if it didn't connect there, like I said, fully, but still, their intentions aren't really just to get map control. And they're actually pushed up mid here. They found their way through onto CT Arch, and they could very well go for the B split. That's the only thing that makes sense right now. Delpang sticking behind, gonna find himself a frag. Does get taken down by Misto, but. Actually, they're doubling back here for an A play, interestingly, as they've worked out where the bulk of the players are, and they were both left over at the B bomb site, forced for the rotation. Here they come in, but there's the bomb planted, and they've only got pistols. So, yeah, good luck, SF. Good luck. Oh, well, he's SF, isn't he? You can't count him out.
Super Fighter almost getting a second kill on HMP. He's backing away. He's like, whoops. He's ain't like, gonna get killed.
Yeah, man, don't.
That's not gonna happen.
It's like one of those situations where it's like, yeah, I'm gonna get the kill. You get dinked. So nope. I'm back. I'm fine.
I'm out of it. Not worth it. I'm too young to die.
Teammates can deal with this.
We just found out that Na'Vi actually beat virtus.pro and kicked them out of the tournament.
Wow.
That's huge news for the Ukrainian and Russian fans of Na'Vi, and very horrible news for the Poles, who have lost their sole representative in this tournament.
Amazing.
And virtus.pro actually right now are probably scratching their heads.
I'm going to have to check those demos out, see how that went down, but Shox is
gets better of Delpan there
in the moment here.
That mid. And I like Shox as an AWPer because he's a patient AWPer. He doesn't take that early flick shot. He always actually waits until he's 100% sure that he can make the shot. And there's a split second delay. And it's not because he's slow, but it's because he wants to make sure he gets the kill. And for that reason, his accuracy is pretty high with the AWP. SF renewing the smoke here in Banana. Very, very important smoke. It stops any T attack at its tracks.
This is a rehearsed Molotov here. Let's see where it goes. Let's get the camera.
I think it might go towards dark.
It could be to bounce off the ceiling to land where the camera is centered here as well. That's been a popular one that Titan started to innovate. There it is. It's going to help them get in that bomb site. As the smoke goes deep for coils, they flush out the close range. So only the guys at the back of the site they've got to worry about. And okay, it's a pretty big worry as it's Kiyoshima, but he does eventually go down. And they get the 3v3. Oh, the bomb gets dropped just before the plant is finished.
Shox. Really, really cheeky play there by Shox. Coming in from graveyard, courtyard, getting that shot and backing away. Disappearing into the darkness. This is really annoying here for the terrorists, who were three men up in the bomb site, and all of a sudden, they've lost it. And it was very important that Kiyoshima got that kill as well, because he removed the one-man advantage that LemonDogs might have had. And made it a 3-on-3 situation. Shox able to get the kill, and then the rest of the team finishing off the job. Very nice here by Epsilon. 11-10. They get the round advantage, and they, you know, they get that bit of financial security that they need as well. And it's really important. This has, you know, when you have a game where it's, I love the fish. It looks nice. What type of fish is that, Dan?
I don't know, goldfish.
How can that be a goldfish? Dad? It's a piranha.
It's not a piranha. God damn it! That'd be cool though. But
they should put piranhas. But the thing is, you know when you have a game where the scores are very equal, it's about the economy. It's really about the economy. And one round, it just doesn't mean, like, if you win a round, it's not just about winning rounds. It's about winning important rounds financially. And that was an important round for Epsilon. Because if they had lost another, they would be in a lot of trouble. But Zevez, the entry fragger, will get himself two, three, perhaps, actually. Three for Zevez. So he's completely emptied the bomb site single-handedly. And it looks like Mist 2 and Shox are just going to hide and save their guns. Very, very nice by Zevez, who pretty much tanked into the bombsite. You really did not expect that whatsoever.
And you can see their positions here. This is a pretty good setup they have going. It's going to be hard to attack them. There will be losses incurred, or at least there should be, to attack these positions.
Mist 2's rifling has to be on point, and it looks like it is.
But they're going for this. They're going for the kills. Good nades. They're attacking.
Shox sees Richie fast there, and he missed the shot. Yep. Zealous will get the double.
And I like that happened. That, I mean, LemonDogs, that round, the last time they went for B, they had it. They actually had it. The bomb getting dropped moments before it was planted. That's a really bad situation because the CTs are on top of you, and you have to plant the bomb. You got to put the time, you got to put the clock on them to win that round and force them to move and not run out of time. And we're actually seeing Epsilon with a really fast push here on Banana. But then you effectively remove one player. So it's like a 1v3 instead of 2v3. So really important stuff here. They're actually managing to take a lot of frags here. This aggression down Banana is already paying off dividends. This is already paid off. They're already happy with this. And can they pick up a weapon or two? Let's check them out. It's SF in the front there. SF has been dangerous today.
It's not a bad eco by them actually getting two kills early on and seeing if they can pick up a gun. Well, he gets an AK-47. Nicely done by SF, but a good aggressive push here. And that's the thing with eco rounds. You can go for those stacks and you can actually, with the CZs, do a bit of damage and hurt your opponents. And now they know they're not going towards bomb site B. They know they're going towards A. They haven't seen them in mid, so Shox has this fairly good idea that somebody might be coming from apartments, but his aim was just not on point. Mistu will be waiting for them patiently. He's a sitting duck for Cobra's AK. Now it's up to SF with an AK-47.
No armor, though.
Steam ahead.
So this is going to be hard for him.
But his aim is so good, SF. First kill for him. SF going into the bomb site, checking every single possible angle. He does not want to be surprised. Zealous will surprise him.
That's a great eco there. They got three frags, and three frags is decent. It's pretty good. They're getting the money down, and it's a good time to, you know, have some impact at least onto the opponent's economy. And you get, and it's not just that, you get money yourself for getting the kills. So every little bit helps. That's a nade. That's a smoke. It's a couple of flashes. It all helps. Every little bit helps, especially on this level. Yeah. So let's have a look on the overlay here to see exactly what's going on. And LemonDogs making a move through for map control again. And Epsilon this round, they want to just give up Banana completely. No aggressive plays. LemonDogs slow and steady to try to take that map control. They're working their way in apartments here. We've got Zealous. You know, he's really far in. And this is Epsilon's decision to give it away. And maybe it's in part because they don't have many grenades. And that's probably what it is, because grenades really help you fall back safely from positions and not get too exposed. So that could very well be the reason. Either way, LemonDogs are going to have a lot of map control. That means the ball is well and truly in their court as to what to do. Epsilon are going to have to execute really well and play very well together to stop this, whatever it may be, from LemonDogs. Looks like they're going for the A push now.
Might have to have a change in position as they're pretty badly smoked off. They actually go to a quad. Interesting mid-round boost here over the smokes. And this is really good. So GMX will be able to see anybody coming from boiler or mid. Terrans have to be very careful here. I don't think they're really going to see it. But GMX is going to give away his position. Actually go for an aggressive push. But it's a good choice by him as he takes down Zealous. Will he get the second? He's still alive. Does a tick of damage on HMP. And he throws that defensive flash onto Truckside. Interesting play here by GMX. Good defensive play. Mistu. He sees the bomb. Well, he hears the bomb being planted and he gets the kill. Great play here by GMX, who's been completely unacceptably
so
good.
Nice. So
very,
nice.
Very nice CT play. And I think it's up to, it's really GMX's round there. Yeah. As Epsilon now equalized 12 to 12.
I'm going to show again. So they're really, this is like being such a standard strategy for ages. What GMX saw was he saw a smoke on truck here and a smoke here for pit. Usually what that means, especially with like what he saw after after taking a player down just outside quad on mid, is that the plant goes down here. And even though this is smoked off, he knows by where the smoke's landed, where they're going to plant. Like, he just knows that. He just absolutely knows that because he knows the game so well. So that's why he's able to make those shots and get the spam. And it looked dead on. It was like through a small gap with the FAMAS,
exactly,
for God's sake.
Yeah.
You know, he knows what he's doing.
Yep, yep.
And beautiful stuff. And I love how he got the frag after getting, going for the surprise peek with the FAMAS, and he fell back. He didn't try to go Rambo mode. Yep. He fell back. He took the advantage, ran back. That's so good from GMX.
What a man. Exactly. That's bread and butter CT play there by GMX. Doing a great job. And again, he's getting better and better as we see him. I mean, he's one player that has, you know, shown a huge improvement from being picked up from an unknown French team earlier last year. But LemonDogs have been given control of mid. And they're going to give it away. They'll try and go towards Banana, where they will see a rampaging SF who kills Delpan and does a crap load of damage. Great flash there by his teammate, and SF making the mistake of staying a bit too long. Now it's up to Shox here with a FAMAS. He does get smoked out, and oh my goodness, through the smoke, double kill there for Shox. Amazing play by the Frenchman, who knew, he knew that they were going to be running through. It doesn't matter if you smoke him off. He just has X-ray vision anyway. So now it's up to HMP. It's 3-on-1. LemonDogs lose this. They lose the advantage. He'll be forced on a precarious financial situation. HMP trying to see if he can plant the bomb. At least he's being attacked from every single possible side. And Shox with the third kill for him this round. Excellent defense of bomb site. Great push there by SF. But LemonDogs perhaps should have continued pushing towards bomb site A.
And they're in trouble now. They're in a lot of trouble now because they are getting a very bad money situation. Whereas if Epsilon lose, they can still scrap together a buy. So that's good for them. If LemonDogs lose, they're ecoing. So that's already 15 to 12 if they lose this one. So, I mean, they're actually already ecoing. So it was more or less a similar effect. They've got one round that they can lose, and it's more or less going to be 15.
If they lose the next buy round, it might be the end of the game.
It's looking like that. So they're going to need a plant and a lot of frags here for the money. So let's see if they can manage to do that to give themselves an extra chance to get, at least get overtime. And they're going to go in with the pistols. Oh, there we go, HMP. But this is a very, very hard angle. And Misto is going to get some easy frags.
Really, Misto is a player who's We did not expect him to be this tight and to be this confident. Oh, they get the bomb plant. This is very good for LEMONDOGS. Mistu stops in the last moment. Denied there by Mistu. He's honestly a player that's, number one, really improved. And number two, has been a lot more solid than we thought he would be. 14 kills for him and 19 deaths. I mean, it's a negative kill-death ratio, but he's playing as good as GMX and perhaps even better than SF, who's made some important kills. So, on the other hand, you've got Shox and Kiyoshima doing an excellent job with their positive kill-death ratios, but Mistu, GMX, and SF all playing pretty much the same level. Pretty balanced equation here on Epsilon's side. They're 14-12. This is a very important buy round here by LEMONDOGS. They have to win. Delpan has to do something. He doesn't have the AWP, actually. HMP was playing with the AWP, and HMP is going to lose the AWP as he gets shot down by the Shox. So this is a very interesting choice.
I don't know if I like Delpan picking up the AWP. It's going to really slow him down. Maybe he's just going to pick it up for some, you know, to cover an angle, then drop it in favor of the AK. But they've only got essentially players who are mobile now.
On the T side, it's tough.
So it's going to be interesting to see how this works.
Well, the one man down, and they lose this round. It's going to be the end of the adventure for them. It's going to be the end of their relatively successful bout at DreamHack Summit. The Swedes, well, they're at their home ground. They really want to impress these veterans of 1.6 Delpan, specifically him and HMP. I'm going to show the world that, well, they can play CSGO as well.
Distraction here from Zelos. He's being all over the place. He's trying to sell that fake. He's really selling it right now. And here we go. LEMONDOGS are making their way into the onside. They've got to execute. They've got to get the bomb down. That just has to happen. Nothing else can happen for them. Otherwise, they are really, really in a lot of trouble. And Delpan does get the spray down, but was too much time lost? Was it too messy? That's really the question. There's no time to plant the bomb.
10 seconds left on the clock.
Oh, what does he do? He has to go for the plot, but he just can't do it. He's surely going to go down, and they let him live a little bit too long. But
it's GMX though against Zelos. He could really end everything for them at the moment. GMX, it's him against Zelos. The bomb's planted. Great job by Delpan to plant the bomb. And GMX will get the kill, and with one health, goodness me, will defuse the bomb. And that's pretty much bye-bye LEMONDOGS. It's match point, but they're not going to have a lot of money to play. Well, actually, they got the bomb plan.
They got
the bomb plan, exactly. Which means they'll be able to go for a full buy. So one last hurrah here for LEMONDOGS. One last hurrah for the Swedes. Mm-hmm. They can keep themselves in the game if they win this round. They can go to overtime if they win the next three. But EPSILON can end it as well. EPSILON have to keep it controlled. They have to play their game. GMX there with their banana smoke.
Only three smokes for LEMONDOGS. This is a really big deal here because the smokes on the T side, it basically means once they throw their smokes, if they don't use them for, you know, to take a site or to hold a site or for a post plant, then they're not really useful. If they like, basically what I'm saying is EPSILON should know that LEMONDOGS' money's so tight that the smokes should give away the play. Once they see the smokes, if they're throwing smokes, and it looks like they are going to go for, are we seeing another pit smoke here from any of the players? No pit smoke, actually. They're just going to go for this push straight up. They're saving the nades. They have all their smoke still, and that's good for them.
Not good, but for Delpan to die in apartments. The bomb is going towards bombsite B. Bombsite B is going to be attacked from two angles. It's a vice attack here. Standard Praetorian type combat by the Swedes as they are trying to take control of the bombsite. But the two CTs have done a great job of staying alive so far. GMX and SF taking a kill each. Kiyoshima taking down Zevas, but Cobra rising to the occasion. It's 1-2. All their dreams could end right now unless Cobra does something quite excellent. Unless he's able to get two kills and the bomb exploding. But he will be shot down there by Mr. GMX, actually, killing himself. And it would have been a very different story indeed. GG all around. There you go. Team EPSILON going on to the semi-finals, as we had expected, but a very, very nice, well, very, very well played there by LEMONDOGS.
Yeah, that last round from them was really cool. I mean, the way that they just try to work their way up with as little uses of the smokes as possible, trying to be really sneaky and catch the CTs, the French CT side off guard, managed to get their way all the way around. We didn't see them do that before. That's like a really hard thing to pull off. And they managed to pull it off, but they just couldn't win the post plant. It was so close.
Yep,
they had so many like close situations. What about that situation with the bomb down? It's like one HP left. I think it was on GMX. And that was just Yep. Nuts.
Absolutely amazing.
Nuts.
Anyway, we're going to have a quick break, but right after that, we'll be doing Nip versus Titan, a huge game, a very, very, very huge
game.
We're
doing that?
Yeah, we're doing that.
Oh, my God.
The El Clasico, Nip versus Titan. It's going to be absolutely amazing. So stick with us. Tell everybody about this stream. We really, really appreciate that, and I'm super excited for this match. But quick break, and we'll be right back.